Hello, everyone. My name is Sergey, and I lead one of the engineering teams working at GenAI here. We're focused on asset generation, and we're also built some of the tech behind the Imagine Together experience you saw yesterday at SPS. Welcome to our breakout session on Snap AR and GenAI. In this session, you're going to hear about our approach to GenAI here at Snap, how we continue to innovate, and how it intersects our AR landscape. As you all know, GenAI has advanced drastically over the past 2 years. We've seen significant innovation across different mediums, including image, video, 3D, and more. And here at Snap, we've been innovators in the space from the very beginning. We brought the power of machine learning to Lens Studio with SnapML over 4 years ago, and since then we've come a long way. At the center of it all is our in-house research and ML teams, the innovation engines that power the technology that powers behind many of your favorite products. GenAI helps power AI and ML lenses, like the 90s lens, Scary Smile, that Snapchatters engage with over 100 million times each day on average. It also drives partnership innovations with brands through sponsored lenses, like NYX Beauty Bestie, that was also shown at SPS yesterday, which uses AR and AI to bring professional makeup artist style recommendations to life. Our chatbot, My AI, can answer tough trivia questions, help plan a hiking trip, and now answer questions on the go as a lens on spectacles. You can even get help building on Lens Studio with our GenAI suite, or bring your lens ideas to life by describing them with the Easy Lens. And beginning today, Snap AI Video can transform a simple text prompt into a video, expanding the creative possibilities of content that you produce and share on Spotlight. We're also making additional investments behind the scenes to make these experiences faster. Our most optimized models run completely on device, bringing AI-powered image generation to Snapchatters at near instant speeds. Our products are already taking advantage of this new technology, starting with real-time AI lenses and expanding to more products in the near future. So here's how we're thinking about AI at Snap. Our goal is to empower users with access to powerful tools and technologies built with safety and transparency in mind. Our community is our best feedback provider, and they're included early on in our product development lifecycle. And in-house proprietary technologies give us better control over outcomes. Now, I'll pass it to Charmaine to share how we think about AI specifically when it comes to AR and authoring.
Hey, thanks, Sergey. I'm Charmaine, and I lead product for Lens Studio. I spend my days and nights thinking about how we author AR. At Snap AR, our motto is dream it, build it. We see AI as a mechanism to bridge the gap between dreaming and building. We're shaping AI's future with open-minded research grounded in real user needs. We want to use AI to remove creation barriers and restore the joy of building. Here's an example. Today, a lens production team here at Snap includes an AR engineer, a studio designer, a VFX designer, and a project manager. But the average person obviously doesn't have access to a world-class lens production team to support ideation, scene building, asset creation, coding. We think we can change that. We don't believe that today's AI will replace the unique skill sets of our creators, and instead, it'll enhance their workflows. Here are some ways we want to approach that. We want to lower the barrier of entry to creation. We want a first-time user experience that accelerates your journey from idea to first draft. We also want to increase productivity. That means you get help faster, you debug faster, which also increases the quality of your lenses. We want to better understand our creators and product gaps based on what our users are actually asking for. And then finally, we want to remove creative blockers. And by blockers, I mean blank canvases and prompts, repetitive tasks, or just other annoying parts of development that are unnecessarily difficult. As Sergey mentioned, today we release Easy Lens in closed beta. It's a part of the Lens Studio GenAI suite to speed up creation from prompt to full first draft. While we were building this, we had to address some really interesting challenges that AI presented to us. How do we use AI to help you build great lenses while also helping you learn how to build great lenses? Or is that the end goal? If someone types in vomiting rainbow, how do we make sure it doesn't look exactly like the classic Snapchat lens, even though it's not, and I promise it's not, trained on any lens data at all? And finally, what's most near and dear to our hearts? How do we make sure creation still feels really fun and satisfying? Here's a sneak peek of where we're landing. We used multi-agent LLMs, where each agent has its own guidelines, goals, and tools. This recreates a world-class lens production team, even if you're running solo. For example, you can call one agent as a lens creator who comes up with a concept or builds a plan, and then another as an AR engineer who can actually help you break down each component with detailed instructions. And then maybe you have a designer who actually creates the assets with different asset generation pipelines. This breakdown and introduction of roles let the LLM have really interesting discussions and collaboration, and eventually gets us closer to solving complex problems like lens creation. We wanted to get the tool out as quickly as possible because we were really excited about it, but we also know that there's a lot to do. We're conducting user test upon user test, iterate and validate what we're working on. In our early closed beta, we're starting backwards from how we normally approach testing new features. We're gonna test with some non-lens creators first, see if it helps introduce them to the concept of AR. And then we'll go back to all our existing lens creators, making sure that you all benefit from it too. This is really cool because it lets us look at all of this from a completely different and fresh angle. We hope you're as excited about it as we are. But GenAI is in its early days, which means there are some scenarios that GenAI is not so good at tackling just yet. So we thought it'd be fun to wrap up this presentation by showcasing some of our favorite GenAI fails. Don't worry, GenAI is not taking any of our jobs. Here are some of the early generations that we had. But with that, thank you so much, everyone. That's the end of our GenAI presentation.